Price!
Yeah!
Good to see you! Welcome, welcome, welcome!
Welcome, children!
Yeah, 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 yeah. You guys, you had a lovely week?
Yes, we did!
Lovely one!
Alright, you know this dance?
We
see. One, two, three, and you don't stop.
No, not properly. I know that kids, they know better than you. Welcome to Church Kids. My name is Uncle Charles.
And my name is Uncle Kapali Francis.
Uncle Mark Elijah here.
We are so happy that you're here with us. Now today, we are going to play a nice game. The first thing you're going to do, get a paper and a pen or a pencil. Go. In 1 second, everybody gets a paper, okay, or a book, or a pencil, or a pen. Hurry up. Okay. Hurry up. Where are you? Where are you? Where are you?
Yeah.
Good job.
Right.
Good
there.
Job. Good job, everyone. Now, okay, what you're going to do,
yep,
we are going to draw without seeing what we are drawing.
Okay.
All right? So I mentioned something. You draw it. Mm. The first thing you're going to do, put your papers on your head.
All right.
Put your paper or your book on your head. All right. Now, are you ready?
Yes.
You're going to draw for me a cat.
A cat.
And I'm counting for you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Stop. Stop, stop, stop. Show me your cat. Show me your cat. Show me your cat. Woo! Ha ha! You guys, you don't know.
This is a cat.
That's a fish. Wonderful. Another one, another one, another one.
Okay.
Another one.
One
now, children, you're also going to show me.
Yeah.
You're going to show me. Uh-huh. Papers on your head.
Okay.
You're going to draw. Are you ready?
We are ready, Uncle Kapali.
Are you ready?
We are ready.
Uh-huh. You're going to draw for me. You're going to draw for me, Uncle Kapali. Hey. Draw for me, Uncle Kapali. I'm counting down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Stop! I want to see. Let me see. Uncle Kapali. Let me see. Uncle Kapali. Let me see. That's a dog. You people, you don't know. Children, show me. Wonderful. You people, you know. You're better than these guys. Wonderful, wonderful. Now, for the rest of the fun, let's join our service. And join us, join us, join us, join us. Now, let's go, let's go, let's go. Come!
Hello everyone, my name is Leona and welcome to church. I'm here with
Abigail. You're going to have lots of fun.
Wherever you're watching us from, YouTube, Facebook, or even on air, you are very welcome. But before, let's pray. Hands together.
Eyes closed.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We thank you that you have loved us and protected us, Lord. I pray that as we are going through this sermon and praise and worship, that we'll have fun and that we'll learn something in you. In Jesus' name I've prayed.
Amen. Amen. Now let's prepare ourselves for praise and worship.
Hello, children.
Hi.
Are you ready to praise the Lord?
Yay.
Okay, let's rise up on our feet and praise the Lord together. Like this. Let's go. Jesus, we lift your name on high. Your name on high. Be lifted high. Come on.
Jesus, we lift your name on high. Your name on high. Be lifted high.
Jesus, we lift your name on
That was wonderful. Did you have fun in praise and worship?
Yes, I did.
I guess you prepared your notebooks, pens, and Bibles. Let's learn together.
Wow, wow, wow. That was awesome worship. The Bible says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And the house of the Lord is in your house. The house of the Lord is in your community, in that small group where you meet together with your friends to worship the Lord. Tell me, how have you been? How is your family doing? I know God has kept you very, very well. Well, my name is Dora Watava, one of the pastors in the children's ministry. And I'm so excited to share with you God's word today. Let's pray. Hands together, eyes closed. Jesus, thank you so much for your word. I pray that every boy and every girl will pay attention. And I pray that they will learn. In Jesus' name I pray. And all God's children say, amen. Well, last week, we learned to think others first. And I hope that you are doing that. Did you know that it is May already? Yes, May is here. And as Watoto Church, during the month of May, we teach about family. We take some time off and learn what does God say about family. So from today until the month of May ends, we are going to teach you what God's plan for family is. Today, our lesson is my family. Let's say it together. Now, can you shout it out? My family. Very good. Now, the question is, what is family? Well, share with your neighbor. What do you think a family is? A family is a group of people staying and living together. A parent or parents, brothers, sisters, children. A nuclear family. Or an extended family made up of parents or a parent, judges, cousins, aunties, uncles, and everybody else. That is a family. So tell me, what do you like about your family? No, why don't you just stand to the people you are watching the service with and tell them what you like most about your family? Well, I love being around my family, and I like talking to each and every one of them. You know, it's so sad when you are all alone and you have no one to talk with. Let's learn from the Bible how family began. In your Bibles, turn to Genesis chapter 2, verses 18 to 24. Genesis chapter 2, 18 to 24. It says, the Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him. Now the Lord God had formed of the ground all the beasts of the field and all the birds of the air. He brought them to the man to see what he could name them. And whatever the man called each living creature, that was its name. So the man gave names to all the livestock, the birds of the air, and all the beasts of the field. But for Adam, no suitable helper was found. So the Lord God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took one of the man's ribs and closed up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of the man, and he brought her to the man. The man said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She will be called woman, for she was taken out of man. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will be one flesh. So from this scripture, we see how family began. Adam and Eve were the first man and woman, and God performed the first wedding. He joined them together, and they started a family, and they had children. God's desire has always been that families begin that way. God desires that a man and a woman come to church or to a place that they have designated, and they have a wedding. The woman is dressed in white, looks very lovely. She puts on a gown. The man puts on a suit, and he looks so handsome. And they come before God, and they make promises to one another. They promise to stay together. They promise to love one another. And they ask God to help them. And the pastor says, I pronounce you husband and wife. And they start staying together. And they have children. Now, children, all of us, we are gifts from God. We are blessings to our parents. Well, some of us, our parents are not yet husband and wife. But that doesn't mean you're an accident. No, my dear friends, you are not accidents. God planned for you. Because the Bible tells us that the reason why he wants the husband and the wife to come together is for them to have godly offspring. That's Malachi chapter 2 and verses 15. Now, godly offspring simply means children that are like God. The Bible tells us that before you were born, before you were formed in your mother's womb, God knew you. So do not feel like you're a mistake. Do not feel like you do not count. Because, hey, you count. God knows you. God knows all about you. Your parents could have died, or simply your mom didn't tell you the story about how you came to be. But one thing I know, God knows you, and God loves you very, very much. God blesses us in our families because we are gifts to our families. You see, when you receive a gift, you don't ask for it. Somebody simply thinks about you and gives you a gift. What you do is receive the gift. I want you to know that you are a gift. You are special to God and to your family. But above all, when you believe in Jesus, the Bible tells us in John chapter 1, verse 12, to as many as believed in him, Jesus gave them the right to become children of God. On top of you being a child in your home, a son or a daughter to your parents, you are a child of God. And that is the best thing ever. You belong to a bigger family, which is the family of God. If you have never asked Jesus to come into your life, that means you are not in God's family. But if you'd like Jesus to come into your heart so that you belong to his family, I want you to pray this prayer with me. And I want you to mean it from the bottom of your heart. Pray after me. Say, dear Jesus, I thank you so much for loving me. I thank you so much for dying on the cross for my sins. Jesus, I believe in you. Jesus, write my name in the book of life. In your name I pray. Amen. Now, if you say that prayer, know for sure that right now you are a child of God. But I also want to pray with you that God will help you realize that you are special, that you are unique, that you are loved by him. But above all, you are not a mistake. He planned for you. Let's pray. Jesus, I thank you so much for all the boys and girls. I thank you that you love them. I thank you that you have a wonderful plan for their lives. Lord, I pray that each and every one of them will experience your love. They will know that you love them. They will know that you planned for them. They will love you too as well. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hey, I want you to have a conversation this week with your parents and find out, Mom, Dad, did you have a wedding? If they didn't, talk about it and see what can be done. I hope you enjoyed the service. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hello, my name is Samuel.
My name is Patricia.
Jillian. Paz.
I like Watoto because we get everything we need.
I'll carve your name into the sun. Love you till my days are done.
When I grow up, I want to be an aeronautic engineer.
I'll never let you go.
When I grow up, I want to be a doctor.
I want to be a pilot when I grow up. I love Ototo because we care for the community.
I like playing cards with my mother and playing with my friends.
Thank you for loving me.
Thank you for loving me.
Thank you for loving me.
Thanks, Pastor Dora, for the lesson. Let's learn our memory verse. It comes from the book of Psalms, chapter 127, verse 3. It says, children are a gift and a blessing from God. It simply means, us children are gifts to our parents. Let's say our memory verse one more time. Psalms, chapter 127, verse 3. It says, children are a gift and a blessing from God. Psalms, chapter 127, verse 3.
Welcome back from the lesson. I hope you had a great time. Come on, rise up on your feet as we do the next song.
Open our eyes to see the need. Open our ears to hear the cry. The brokenhearted, the wounded soul, you're calling us. Song of peace, declaring freedom and hope for all.
you learned something from our lessons. So I've learned that I'm a gift to my parents. Let's have a closing prayer. Hands together, eyes closed. O Lord, my Father, one thank for the gift of life, one thing that have protected us and guided us during this week. As the week ahead of us, may please protect us and guide us. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. See you next time. Bye-bye.